If you've watched the Winter Olympics, this sport may look familiar. It's curling, and in upstate New York, it's hugely popular. The Schenectady Curling Club was founded in 1907, and today this club is the home ice for Team Beef.
Team Beef!
There's five of us in the Schenectady Curling Club that are on Team Beef, and I'm a member of that team. As an organization, Team Beef typically works with runners across the country, and I was having a conversation with Gene O'Toole, who's the director here at the New York Beef Council, and just through, you know, we were sitting there having coffee one morning. It was a very cold February morning. We were sitting in a coffee shop just down the street and talking, and she goes, "I've got a fun idea. What if we take Team Beef, and instead of doing running, what if we do curling?"
I wasn't sure exactly the whole universe that we were about to get involved in. And since then, it's really been a very expanding viewpoint of mine, that learning about the organization and the industry and, you know, getting to have some fun curling while doing it, it's been eye-opening.
The best thing about Team Beef is we're reaching out to a whole different group of people that we may not normally reach out to, whether it's runners or curlers or mountain bikers or whatever sport it happens to be. They may not be including lean beef as a protein source in their diet, and by letting Team Beef do that, we may be bringing in a whole new group of customers.
In curling, the team slide heavy stones called rocks on a sheet of ice toward a circular target. They sweep the ice to help smooth the path for the rock. Closest to the center scores big. For Team Beef, being on the ice week after week competing against other teams actually opens the door to conversations about beef.
It's definitely a different idea to have a curling team representing Team Beef, but I'll tell you, we've had so many interesting conversations. So curling, I'll take a step back and say that curling's a very social sport. While you're on the ice, you're serious, you're competitive, you're playing against the other team, then afterwards we'll sit down and they go, "What's the deal with Team Beef? What's the story there?" And that's where we get a chance to talk about, beef as a larger picture, beef and what some of the beef producers are doing, and tell that story. But it's also a chance to talk about lean beef is a great protein source.
It's that connection when they see Team Beef and they are inquisitive that they start asking questions, "Well, what do you mean, Team Beef?" And that's when the conversation starts. And when these guys are done curling, they all get together with the team that they're opposing, sit down, have a few beers, and all of a sudden, the conversation about steaks and roasts and production, and these guys got to see that. They're MBA certified, so they're able to talk farm to fork and have great knowledge of that.
That all stems from, "Hey, what's Team Beef? What's that all about?" And then usually we can spiral the conversation into, "Hey, let me teach you about what I know and about all the industry, and maybe open your eyes a little bit and appreciate it a little more as well."
There was a gentleman, and I sat and talked to him for probably 20 minutes, and as he left, he goes, "I'm gonna go have a conversation with my wife. She thought red meat was bad, and I'm gonna have to go have a conversation and tell her that she needs to rethink this." And so that was a really cool feeling for me, is that, like, yes, it's just one person, but hey, you know, that's one person, one person, one person, and it all adds up. You know, we can't hit everybody at once, but if I can have a meaningful, you know, a 20-minute conversation about beef and beef production with someone, that's really cool.
During the season, the Team Beef members curl several times a week, and they travel to tournaments. In this way, they make one-on-one contact with scores of others who can't miss the beef messages on their team gear.
You can't help but see it, whether it's on our jacket, whether it's on jackets, whether it's somewhere. Somebody's going to see that and say, "Hey, what's, you know, tell me the story about Team Beef."
They got jackets, put the Team Beef patches on, and then we got them the shirts, Team Beef, because, you know, their jackets will come off eventually with them running up and down and sweeping. So that's a nice layer.
But the fact that people like Dave and the whole team can go to a group that has nothing, no idea about beef or the benefits of beef, and they can, it's a conversation starter. When they have the Team Beef t-shirts on, well, what's that? And then we're empowering another group of people to spread the good word of what we're doing. So this is an extremely unique opportunity for the Beef Council to have somebody else spread the word.
Team Beef Curling is funded by checkoff dollars. None of the Team Beef members have an agricultural background, so they visited Doug Giles's farm to become more equipped to share the beef story.
He showed us what a typical day on his farm is like and what he does and some of the challenges he's facing, and that was really eye-opening, because while I have been on a couple farms myself, I still learn something new every time I step foot on a farm. And then my teammates, this was for many of them the first time they'd ever stepped foot on a cattle farm. So for them to see that was really cool.
the Beef Council has provided us the opportunity to go basically learn more about different aspects of the industry. So we went on a producer visit, saw basically how cows are raised and all of the things that go into them.
I can't say enough good things about the Beef Checkoff and the New York Beef Council for what they're doing to promote beef. It is really quite important, I do believe. And so as I mentioned earlier, beef producers, they're really hardworking folks.
And at a practice session, cattle producer Doug Giles and Gene O'Toole of the New York Beef Council had some fun taking curling lessons and talking over the kinds of opportunities Team Beef can help to create now and in the future.
This is more than just a patch on our sleeve. Team Beef is where we are representing all the producers across the country, and that brings us a lot of pride to be able to do that. That's special for us to be able to talk about beef and talk about that message.
I've had beef conversations in the strangest places, and to have it on ice and in curling, I think is the greatest opportunity ever because it's unexpected. And if these are five guys that sit down with five guys after, that's five more people that know, and they'll go home and go, you're not gonna believe what I heard today. Or next time they're in the grocery store, they're gonna look at beef a little bit differently, maybe hopefully a little more positively.
Team Beef Curling is sponsored by the New York Beef Council with checkoff funding from the Iowa Beef Council, both members of the Federation of State Beef Councils. On the ice with Team Beef, I'm Brian Baxter reporting for NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.